For the latest film interviews, reviews and everything making news in pop culture, subscribe to Film Companion now.
Hello and welcome to Film Companion. This is a Satyajit Ray special and we're wishing the maestro a very, very happy birthday. If this makes it feel like he's still around, it is because it does seem that way. His films are so classical, so timeless that many of them feel like they could have been made right here, right now, today. So for his 100th birthday, we at Film Companion, or rather I, decided to make a list of the top 10 Satyajit Ray's films. Obviously, this is a very subjective list and I am going to have to warn you right away that Pothair Panchali is not on this list. Why? Because it is as timeless, as classical a film can be, and yet I felt it couldn't be on this list because, well, you'll soon see why. Anyway, let's begin with number 10.
Aranya Dinratri.
Four middle-class urbanites take off for a vacation in a forest. And away from civilization, their true natures emerge. The critic Pauline Kael called the film a study of the cultural tragedy of imperialism. The young men, she said, are self-parodies, clowns who ape the worst snobberies of the British. I would say they end up reflecting the worst snobberies of us Indians too. At number 9, I'm going with Abhijaan. For some reason, and not just because it stars Vahida Rehman, I've always felt this film to be a twin, a companion piece to Basu Bhattacharya's Teesri Kasam. Shatranj Ke Khiladi may be Ray's only Hindi feature film, but Abhijaan is a masterclass on how an auteur can take a bunch of Hindi film tropes and elevate them to the Himalayas. And at number 8,
Oshani Shanket.
This scorching drama is set against the 1943 famine of Bengal, but instead of a sweeping view of a calamity, Ray focuses on just a few people and on nature. The opening image of a gently flowing river and a woman's hand emerging from the water, it sets up the film's concerns and aesthetics so beautifully.
At number 7, Mahanagar.
A top candidate, I guess, for everyone's favorite Ray film, along with the next entry on this list. The lipstick scene is justly celebrated, but what's really amazing is the subtlety with which the master treats this melodramatic material. It doesn't scream women's lib, it just says, this is a woman's life.
At 6, I'm going with Noyak.
Uttam Kumar is magnificent as an actor caught in angst, and more angst. He plays a stage actor who becomes a movie star. His stage guru tells him, I know there is glamour in the movies, but there is no art. Ray proves him wrong with a film whose glamorous stars, including Sharmila Tagore, create a dizzying edifice of art.
At 5, Parosh Pathar.
Ray demonstrated his lighter, quirkier side in quite a few films, but I'm going to recommend this rather underseen one about a bank clerk who discovers a stone that can turn metal into gold. The film has the simplicity of a Panchatantra fable or a morality tale, and it's a great example of how a great filmmaker can leave his fingerprints, his touches, even on a so-called minor work.
At number 4, I propose Pratidwandi.
This first installment of Ray's famous Calcutta trilogy is also his best. It's about youth and the big city and aligning oneself with causes and also being gloriously confused about life. And all of this is reflected in the film's style, which has scenes like a psychedelic stretch of whip pants towards the end. It's a very different Ray at work here.
At number 3, Jalshagar.
This is the story of a once great zamindar, a great patron of the arts. He's one of those people to whom a great Thumri or Ghazal performance is worth all the money in the world, even if it costs him his dwindling fortune. Chabi Biswas gives an all-time great performance in this most magnificent ode to ruin. It's a must if you're a music lover.
At number 2, Apur Sanchar.
Okay, this is the reason Pothair Panchali is not on this list. While I love the story of Apur as a child, this final installment packs in the memories of the character we have grown to love and care for from the earlier two entries in the trilogy, and it explodes with the quietest epiphanies. The way the Soumitra Chatterjee character comes full circle with another little boy like Apur himself is incredibly touching.
And finally, at number 1, Charulata.
From the early shot of Madhavi Mukherjee going from window to window to glance at the happenings on the street, to the scene on the swing, to the freeze frame ending, this is a classic all the way through. If there's one film of Ray's you want to pick with a gun to the head, it's this deep dive into the mind of a lonely wife. So that was my list, and I'm sure you're going to have disagreements. So what are your top 10 Ray films? Let us know in the comments section and keep watching Film Companion.